And now with an Outlook Portland editorial reply, Things from Another World presents the King of the Monsters, Godzilla.
People of Portland, today I'm here to talk to one very specific group of people, an assemblage of molecular detritus so lacking in basic decency and virtue that it scarcely seems right to include them in what we call humanity. I am, of course, referring to the hecklers. A loathsome and repellent form of carbon, the heckler is also a parasite, siphoning away the time and energy of others, draining precious moments from our too short existence in this realm. The heckler, my friends, cannot create, but nor can he destroy. He lacks even that power. The heckler possesses only the power to interrupt, to annoy. Lest there be any doubt, to stand on a stage in the judgment of one's peers is difficult. To do so in the performance of one's own creation, doubly so. And thus, any such performer, whatever their talent or caliber, deserves a measure of respect. The heckler, on the other hand, deserves only scorn and a good savage beating with a beer bottle and maybe an expertly applied garden hose with a rusted brass nozzle. This I say unto thee, people of Portland, this we know to be true. Thank you.
This has been an Outlook Portland editorial reply featuring the King of the Monsters, Godzilla, brought to you by Things from Another World. Whatever you're into, they have just the thing for your collection. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Mr. Big Jim Willig and Don Frost talking about the art of stand-up comedy in Portland. As somebody performing stand-up comedy, you have to deal with hecklers. How long does it take to get that knack or to get used to it, or do you?
I got on stage and this guy just yells out, "Look at the tits on him!" And I'm just like, you have no idea. That was the first time I ever been heckled, you know what I mean? And like, I'm standing up there and like every word, I would start to say something and then the guy would say something else and everyone would laugh. And I would just, I quit comedy for like 2 months. But when I came back, all my material was about that subject of manhood. But I mean, after that, no heckler they'll say things, and I'm not the type of comic where I'll just like you know, cuss at them in your whole life, look at your wife. You know, I'll either agree with what they say and then build on it, because then they'll get kind of excited. They're like, oh yeah, I'm funny too, and then they'll shut up.
Dealing with hecklers is integral to comedy, because so much of comedy comes from heckling. You know, most comics grew up where they were picked on in school, so the hecklers were just the other kids in the class. So learning how to deal with them kind of prepared them for when they're in a club and they get some drunk, like, say something funny or whatever, and they're yelling stuff out at you. So the more you can rely on that aspect of your life kind of gives you more of an arsenal to deal with the random drunk in the audience. I personally love hecklers because it provides an improvisation that you can't plan for, and so much comedy comes from the unexpected. It's pretty much where the crux of it.
It's a spark.
It is, yeah. So it gives you the opportunity to kind of just go off. When it happens right, it is unmatched. But when it goes so wrong, so very, very wrong, there's nothing that can save it. And at that point, you might as well just like, you know what, if I can't beat him, join him. And you just get off stage and you just get wildly, wildly drunk. There are times when it'll almost come down to fisticuffs, because people think that they can just interact with you. Like, you're up there kind of talking to them directly. Like, no, I'm talking to the group. This is a form of entertainment. I'm being paid to do this. You paid money to come listen to me speak. Now you're ruining that and ruining it for everybody else around you because you think you're just as funny or talented as the person that you've just come to see.
Does, you mentioned going and getting roaring drunk and the heckler being drunk. Does alcohol, and the fact that the crowd is drinking, does that make it easier or harder to be on stage doing comedy? Does alcohol help or hurt?
I don't think it really matters, because I you know, I've done shows in prisons and they're not drinking, you know? And it's like, they laugh just as hard. There's coffee shops, I've done like high schools with, you know, kids. And I don't think alcohol really plays a factor in how much the crowd is going to laugh at you or if it's going to ease them up. Because, I mean, you laugh during the day and you're not drunk. A lot of people aren't. That, to me, I don't think it matters.
Alcohol makes it easier for an audience to laugh because the inhibitions are lowered. They're more apt to accept something that when they're sober, they may have an issue with the topic of, but the way you're presenting it at the time, they have an easier time kind of laughing at it. But like, you know, we've done comedy in coffee shops. That's the hardest, because that's the opposite of alcohol. People are not just sleepy and chuckly. They are very much focused on analyzing everything that you're saying that's coming out of your mouth. So it's a little bit harder to get away with a lot of the things you can in a club or a bar that you can at like a high school or a coffee shop or a prison, if you will. Yeah. Are they booking right now?
See, that's where we disagree. You know, it's like, to me, I'm just like alcohol.
Point, counterpoint.
You know.
Your thoughts, go.
The thing is like, you know, I really don't like a really overly drunk audience because it's no fun. And once again, it's like hecklers will, some people will just be like, oh, I'm part of the show too. And like, I remember one time this heckler would not shut up. And it was like, I spent probably 20 minutes of my show bouncing things off of this person. And after the show, this lady came up to me and she's like, can I get, you know, where you're going to be at next? She's like, you know, I really thought that heckler ruined it because I wanted to see your material. I don't want to see you deal with a drunk person. I mean, if you think about it, like, if it's like parents, you don't want to see someone yelling at their kid all the time. Instead of like, you show up to do this job to make these people laugh, but they don't want to, because in a weird way, they feel embarrassed for that person. Because if you're just railing on them and making them look stupid, the other people are just like, oh, I'm glad I'm not him. And they're not, I think that takes away from the fun. You know, it's kind of like that kid in class that just won't shut up.
We should probably end on something amusing. Say something funny.
Yeah.
No.
Excellent. Well done.
I'm not your chuckle monkey.
Chip Willig and Don Frost. My name is Rick Emerson. If you find me even moderately amusing, you can find out more about me by going to rickemerson.com. And full disclosure, you can hear Jim Willig on The Rick Emerson Show every Friday doing a segment called Humor Me Comedy 101, where he talks about a specific comic or a comedic performance that is important or inspired him as a performer. Thank you guys for coming on today. And
no problem.
Best of continued success in all things, my friend. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Insert trademark catchphrase here. We will see you next Sunday right here on Outlook Portland. And then we laugh.